Hi everyone, my name is Shai from SAP's product management team. In this video, I'm going to show how to extend SAP Business One web client with your own UI and your own business logic. In this example, we will extend two system views with two scenarios. The first one is the business partner's detail view. We will add a section to this view named Sales Assist. This view will contain the last five items that were purchased by this business partner. This grid will contain two columns. The first one is simply a text column, and the second one is a clickable button column. Clicking on that column will open Google search for that item. This extended business logic will allow a salesperson to get more information about this customer's latest purchases. This concludes the business partner detail view extension. The next view we are going to extend is the sales quotation detail view. In the sales quotation detail view, we are going to add a validation on a system field. We would like to verify that in each sales quotation, the user will provide the customer reference number. Let's see an example. We create a new sales quotation, then we select the business partner. We will go to the items grid and add an item to the sales quotation. And according to the normal system behavior, now we should be able to add the sales quotation. Let's click on Add and View and see what happens. We will see that there was an extension to the system behavior. We will see a message box saying, please provide a customer reference number, and the document was not added to the system. The user understands he has to fill this field, and only then he will be able to add the document. We saw two examples of how we can extend the system behavior. Now we will show how to create these examples using our development tools. You can read how to install your own development environment in the description of this video. We are using Visual Studio Code with our web client development plugin. This plugin enables us to run a wizard that will take us step by step in the process of creating the extension. We choose SAP Business One web client and click on Next. In the next step, we can choose between a tile extension application and a UI API application. We choose the UI API and click Next. Now we need to fill some basic information about our extension. This includes the application ID, the version, and the application provider. The next step is the interesting part of the wizard. In that step, we will need to provide the module name and the view name that are going to be used in our project. And we are able to select the view we want to extend. This view can be either a system view or a UDO UDT view. In our case, we will choose the business partner's detail view. In this list, we can see all the supported views that we can extend. To search for the business partner detail view, we will start typing BU, and it will filter out the relevant views. We select the business partner detail view and click on Next. In the next step, we will need to copy the URL of the page we want to extend and paste it here. Let's go to the web client and open the business partner detail view. We will copy the URL and go back to Visual Studio Code and paste it in the wizard. We're almost done. We just need to click on Next, review the summary, and click Finish and wait while the project is being created.
After the project is created, we need some minor changes to make it run in our environment. We will locate the layout file of our project. Inside this file, we will need to provide a GUID value that will determine where our new button is added on the system page. To get the desired GUID value, we will need to open the web client,
click F12,
and use our web client inspector to load the page GUID values Then we can choose the GUID value of the control we would like to put our button before. In this case, we're selecting the edit button. We will copy the GUID of the edit button and paste it into our project. Now our project is ready to run in our environment. Before running the project, let's review the default code it comes with and understand how it operates. Inside the controller folder, we have a JavaScript file which contains the business logic of the project we created. Each module added to the project will have its own JavaScript file that contains the logic. By default, the file is created with some event handler functions, and it will contain also the onButtonClick function. This function will be called when our newly added button is clicked. The default code of this function is very simple. It will call the service layer to get the company information and then display it in a message box. The definition of which function will be called when the button is clicked is inside the layout.json file. In order to preview this functionality, we can right-click on the layout file and click on Preview. We can see the result. We have a new button that is located before the Edit button. When we click on it, we will get the company information and display it in a message box. We can see our extension is working good on the Business Partner page. What we want to do next is to extend our project to handle another page. We want to handle the sales quotation page. To do that, we will right-click on the manifest.json file and select the Add View option. This will launch the same wizard we saw at the beginning, but it will launch it from the middle because we no longer need the basic project configuration. We can see the wizard was launched from the module step. We will fill the module information and we will select the sales quotation detail page that we want to extend. In the next step, we are required to paste the URL of the page we want to extend. So let's go back to the web client, copy the URL, and paste it into the wizard. The next step is just a summary, and then we can finish the wizard, and the new page will be added to our project. This completes the first part of our video, which was how to create a project from scratch using our wizard. What we're going to do now is we're going to see how this functionality is added to the project. We have the Sales Assist page with a new section and a new grid that were added to it. Let's review how these new controls were added in the layout file. Let's review bpsalesassist.json. We can see this file contains several controls that are added to our page. The definition of these controls comes inside the overlay section, and we are using the after keyword to define the location of the new controls. The first control we are adding is of type section. This is the sales assist section. Inside this section, we will define a subsection and a group named recent items sold. Inside this group, we have the definition of the grid. Inside the definition of the grid, we can see the rows data property, which contains the data binding to our data source. In our scenario, the grid will contain the last 5 items that were sold to this business partner. Later in this video, I will show how the data source is created and how it is linked to this control. Our grid contains 2 columns. The first column shows the item code, and this column is an input box. The second column shows the item name, and it is actually of type button, so it is clickable. We can see that inside the second column, we have a press property, which contains the definition of the function that will be activated when that column is pressed. We've completed the review of the layout file. Let's move on to the business logic file, which is the bpsalesassist.javascript. The first function we're going to review is the onDataLoad. This function is called when the page is loaded. Inside this function, we're using a service layer oDataQuery to get the last five items that were purchased by the business partner. After getting this information from the service layer, we are using the function setCustomizedData.
We create the demo data source, which is referenced by the grid.
The next and the last function in this file is the function that responds to the click on the grid. This function is really simple. We are getting the index of the clicked column, getting the item code and item name, and then we will open a new tab with a Google search on that item. This concludes our review of the business logic and the layout of the business partner detail page. We will now have a similar review of the sales quotation page. Let's go to the web client and open the sales quotation page. Our extension is catching the click event on the add button. Then we will check the customer reference number if it is empty or not. And if it is empty, we will not allow to add this document. So basically, this is a scenario of a system field validation. In our case, the validation is just checking if the field is empty or not. Let's go back to Visual Studio Code and see how it's done. First, let's review the layout file. In this case, the layout file is very simple. We use the on keyword along with the GUID of the add and view button. To get the GUID, we need to open the web client and activate the web client inspector. We have the sales quotation page open. We click on F12 to get the debug information, and we will go to the web client inspector to review the GUID of the button we want to catch the event for. Now we can use this GUID in our project to let the project know we want to respond to the click on this button. We can see the definition of the press event contains the keyword before, which means that we want to process the click on that button before the system behavior occurs. Let's review the function we call when the button is clicked. In general, it's very simple. We just get the control we want to validate, which is done in line 15. We can see the control's GUID is defined inside a const at the beginning of the file. We get the value of the control and check if it's empty. If it is empty, we will display a message box stating the validation failed. Then we will stop the default system behavior by calling prevent default. Now our project is complete and we can show how to package and deploy it into our production environment. To package the project, we will right-click on MTA YAML and click Build MTA. When the packaging process is done, we can find our package in MTA Archives folder. Now that the package is ready, we can go to the Extension Manager, import our package, and after the import process is complete, we will be able to assign our extension to any company in the landscape. After selecting the package file, we will upload it into the system, and then we can go to the Company Assignment tab.
We will click on the company we want to assign our extension to, click on Assign, and select our newly added extension. We will click on Next, accept the default user permissions, and then click Finish. Now we can go to our production environment and log into the company we've assigned our extension to. After logging into the company, we will go to the business partner detail page and see if our extension is working there. We'll click on the business partner tab and click on the business partners tile. Go to the business partner detail page. There we can see our extension is active and working. If you want further information about our UI API or you want to review the source code for this sample, you can find it in the link below in the video description. Thank you, everyone, and have a great day.